and welcome back to my channel once again. Okay. Okay, so today I'm going to be showing you guys how to decorate a buttercream cake with a spoon. Yes, I'm going to be showing you how to create a beautiful rustic or textured buttercream cake with just a spoon. So if you want to see how that goes, stay tuned and keep watching.
So guys, we're going to be using my Swiss meringue buttercream again. This time, this is all the buttercream I use, and it is amazing. It is amazing, and I'm not even exaggerating. So I'm going to put the link right up here if you guys want to see how I make this. And so I'm going to show you how to prep it for use. Usually I make my Swiss meringue buttercream in batches, and then I take out the little I want to use at every point I want to use it. You get it? Okay. So most people tell you to like put it in the microwave or put it in the mixer and you whip it again with your mixer, but you don't necessarily have to do that. You don't have to do that at all. All you have to do is put it in the microwave for around maybe 10-15 seconds. Don't let it be too liquidy so it doesn't become like, you know, like milk kind of. So, and then you can stir it really well with your spatula. You have to make sure you stir it vigorously and like crush every lump in the buttercream, and then it is good to use. Like, it is very easy. So I'm going to put the link right up here for you guys to see. And before that, I already prepped my cake and I crumb coated it in the same buttercream, and it is a vanilla cake. My vanilla cake recipe is also up here in case you guys want to see that. And so I'm kind of off my game today. I don't know, I haven't posted in like 6 days. I just Okay guys, so what you want to do is to cover every part of this cake in buttercream. Yeah, so cover every corner of the cake in buttercream. Like, you want to, you don't want to smoothen it yet. All you want to do is you want to make sure every part of the cake is covered. Like, there is no parts where like you can still see the cake or the crumb coated part peeping out. You want to cover every part from the top to the bottom. Like, you don't want to, I'm not really trying to smoothen it, I'm just trying to make sure like it has even coats of buttercream all around it. Yeah. Okay, so guys, recently like I've been very busy. I have had so much going on, and like YouTubing is difficult, especially when you have something like two or more other things that you do. A school, I also work, and I also have another business apart from kicking away, so it is a lot of work. Okay, so but I'm taking it in strides though, and I'm really proud of myself. Okay, so now what we want to do is smoothen all around. Yeah, so this is all we want. So we want it to be straight, and we want buttercream to cover every part. So what I'm trying to do here is I'm not really trying to smoothen the cake. I'm just trying to make sure it is upright, and then that like there is no part sticking out or no part with too much buttercream. We want to make sure there are even coats of buttercream around this cake. Yes, that's what we want to do. So to smoothen it like I did, you don't really need a bench scraper. You can use a knife, or you can still use your spatula. I'm just very used to using my bench scraper. So right now, I want you to look at what I'm doing. You can use a tablespoon or a teaspoon. What I'm trying to do right now is to make this textured design on the cake. And so I'm going to slow this down for like a few seconds so you can see what I'm really doing. What I'm doing is I took the spoon and I fetched some buttercream with it. And then I'm forming like a C-ish. This is in slow motion so you guys can see what I am doing. I'm kind of like writing a C, like an informal or like a not well formed C, the letter C on top of the cake. Did you guys get that's what I'm doing? And it is very easy, and you have to make sure you're like, you're not used doing it with your energy, you're not pressing, because if you press too much, you're going to get to the bottom of your buttercream, and that's not what you want to do. I hope you guys saw what I did there, because I slowed it down a little bit for you guys to see. And if you didn't really see that well, you should rewind it a little so you can see what I did. And then at intervals, you have to clean up your spoon because buttercream gathers on the spoon and doesn't make it foam well after a while. So what you want to do is go around your cake and form like a C-ish, like a curved line, a curved small line, kind of, something like that. And then we're going to clean our spoon again, and then we're going to do the same thing for the top. This cake looks like it won't look nice, but actually it does look nice. All you have to do is maybe put a few flowers on it, or maybe just a big flower, or you can put some sprinkles all around it, and it is good to go. If you don't have cake decorating tools or anything, this is the perfect cake for you to make, and it is beautiful. Like, I wasn't expecting it to look this nice, and I got so many compliments on this cake. It is beautiful. So what you want to do right now is not to scrape or anything. We want to leave it just the way it is. I know it looks rough. This is exactly how it should look. So right now I want to put some artificial flowers on top of it. You can put artificial flowers on these, or you can put candles, or you can do anything. Basically, it is a simple, beautiful, rustic cake. Yes, that is what you want to create, and that is what you created. Okay, now so I need to put flowers in it, and after doing that, okay, you can also like give it away like this, or if you have those colored sprays, you can spray colors on it and makes it really beautiful. It gives it like amazing dimension. So I decided to try that, and what I did was I took my airbrush and put some gold into it, and then I mixed some gold with some rose gold and airbrushed it, and it looked amazing. Like, and I got so many compliments. It looked like two different cakes. So if you guys notice, what I'm doing is I'm putting like a toothpick in the flower. If you stick a toothpick, if you put it on top, it will stick. But you have to know that like if any little thing happens to it, it's going to fall off, and that's not what you want. You want a situation whereby like it can stay on top of your cake and look like it belongs on the cake. So guys, it is time to convert it from that color to white. I know that arrow doesn't do justice for fine. Okay, so this color is so beautiful. So I'm gonna show you guys how I created this right now. So what I did was to make some pink. I wanted rose gold, and I didn't have rose gold in particular. So what I did was to mix some pink gold dust with some gold dust. Yeah. So, and if you mix it together, it won't work. So what you have to do is first spray pink, and then spray gold. And when you're trying to spray, I used vodka, because vodka dries and it won't be dripping off of your buttercream. So if you want to spray on buttercream, make sure you use vodka, or you use some form of alcohol, you know. Okay, so that's what I did. So right now I already mixed it with alcohol, and I'm mixing it with my brush so it won't form lumps, because if there are lumps, it won't come out of your airbrush, and it will get stuck on in the tip, and you don't want that, because that's really stressful. Okay, so now I'm going to put that in my airbrush, and then I am going to spray. Yeah, and after spraying this, it looks so pretty. I'm going to spray it pink first, and then I'm going to put some touches of gold around it. Okay, so guys, for those of you asking me how I made this, this is how I made it. And it was very easy. If you don't have a spatula or anything, you can start initially with a spoon or a knife, but you have to make sure every part of the cake is covered in buttercream. It is very easy to make, and you don't have to spray it if you don't have maybe something to spray or something, you know. Okay, so I hope this video is useful to you guys, and you guys like it, because I enjoyed making it for you. And I hope you like this color, and thank you guys for sticking with me. Right now I'm at about 1,300 subscribers. How the fuck? Thank you guys for subscribing to my channel, and thank you for following me, and thank you for watching my videos, and I'll soon be monetized. It's surreal, actually. Like, how? Okay. Okay, I'm enjoying this YouTube more than I thought I would. I didn't know it was going to be this difficult. I thought it was going to be, you know, just make videos and post, but I didn't need to. Something else that you do, if you have other things you do, it can be very demanding, but it's okay. And I'm loving making these things and showing you guys how I make them, if you can help anyone. So if you know anybody who has a cake business or is just starting out, you can refer them to my page, and like I have videos they can watch, and they can tell me what they would like me to make. Because when I started out, I didn't have, yeah, there are lots of videos about cake making on YouTube, but a lot of them are for home bakers and stuff. They're not really for people that want to start a business or that are doing businesses and stuff. So if you know someone who's just starting out and would like some help, you can refer them to my channel, or share my videos on Facebook or on Instagram or on WhatsApp. Whatever you want to do, that's fine. Okay, thank you guys for subscribing, and thank you for liking all of my videos. I hope you like this one. Keep a like right now, please. Thank you. Because when you like my videos, like, it gets more views, because YouTube gets to show it to more people, because you're telling them that you enjoyed it. So thank you guys for watching, and thank you. And I hope you like this color, because I loved it. And I think after this, I've made about 4 to 5 of this same cake. I hate like posting one cake like 4 or 5 times, so like I didn't post this once. But thank you guys for always watching and staying with me. I hope you enjoy this So thank you, and I'll see you in my next tutorial. Bye.